belong to the same family, the family of God. Bago natin marinig ang kanya bisay para sa ating pamagayin, ay magkaramihin muna tayo ng pagkita ng awit. Ang ating tagapagsalita ko na ngayon ay si Pastor Frederick Paul, a man of God, an ardent student of the Bible. He is from the Adventist Institute of Advanced Studies. So bago natin siya marinig, magkaramihin muna tayo ng pagkita ng awit.
Thank you. Happy Sabbath and good morning, beloved saints. Happy Sabbath. Aren't you happy to be here in the house of the Lord? I am so humbled and so happy. I'm also specially happy this morning for another reason. I saw another Indian in the church. This is the first time in my life I'm meeting an Indian in the Philippines. So I want to very specially welcome my good friend Harish Wani and the monk. Okay? Swagat Karey. Very special. I believe that God is here to speak to us this morning. How true it is, not by might, not by PowerPoint, but by my spirit. Amen?
Amen.
Whether the PowerPoint works or not, we have points of power this morning. Let us all reverently hold on. Amen. Shall we say amen?
Amen.
That's the Spirit of God. Have you attached the audio? Let's go on quickly. Have you attached the audio, please?
Thank you.
We have not come here to listen to an ordinary, foolish human being speak, but we have listened to you all these years, and we want to listen to you one more time. Speak to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. Our subject this morning is entitled as The Bible Bird. We're going to study a story from the Bible this morning that talks about a king who burned the Bible. And I'm going to tell you from the Word of God the power of the gospel. Amen. And what it is to experience God's power and presence and anointing and the Holy Spirit in our lives. And what will happen to you and me if we only listen to this word? I'm going to start with a true story that happened in Romania. In Romania, during the 1960s, when communism was at its height, people were banned from owning a Bible. If you owned a Bible, or if you read a Bible, you would be imprisoned immediately in the Romanian regime. One man got hold of a Bible. He loved the Lord Jesus Christ. And after he loved Jesus, he could not stay quiet. He wanted to share about the love of God. What did he do? He got a typewriter. And he started typing the pages of the Bible, and he wanted to share the Bible, the power of God. This is God's spoken word. This is God's written word. And this is God's amazing word. This word has the power to create. When God saw nothing in this world, and when he said, let there be light, there will be light. And when God says, let there be animals, there was tiger, rhinoceros, bear, and lions. Today you've come here empty. God is going to speak his word to you, and something is going to be created in your life right now. Amen. You will never go home empty like how you came here. Because by the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and the host of them by the breath of his mouth. For he spake and it was done. And he commanded and it stood fast. God's word can change, break, melt, mold, transform, revive, and reform you and me. Amen. Coming back to the story, this man, when he started typing the Bible, you know how our neighbors are. One of his neighbors peeked into the house. He ran up to the police. And he said, hey, be careful. He called the police came and started knocking on his door. Hey, what are you doing? He was caught red-handed, typing the Bible. They took him to the prison, put him there in the jail, and the jailer told him one word. Don't give him any food or water for the next 3 days. You're listening to a true story. You're listening to a true story. When he was inside the prison, nobody gave him food. As he was so hungry, he heard a voice. Meow! What was that? Yeah. It came with a slice of bread in his mouth, and it dropped exactly in his cell. He took the bread and he ate it. Second day, same cat, meow, came with another slice of bread. He took it and ate. Third day, the jailer came. Hey, has your God been feeding you? He said, yes, my God has been feeding me. No, I told my police not to give you food. No, sir, as they were talking, he heard a voice, meow. The jailer looked at the cat and he almost had a heart attack. He said, this is my cat bringing my bread from my kitchen table. Man shall not leave my bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Amen. How many of you really read your Bible this morning? Be honest. Raise your hand. Praise God. Do you know why is he promoted as the ambassador? Because he reads the Bible. Do you want to be an ambassador to Australia? Yes or no? Read the Bible. Praise God. Can you imagine a church? Today we have fasting and prayer, and I'm going to be here. I pray for all of you this morning. Till 4 o'clock, after a short break, we are going to fast and pray. The greatest need of our church is not pastors, is not students from IELTS, is not committees, is not church boards. The greatest need of the church is revival and reformation. If you agree, say amen.
Amen.
If you don't agree, still say amen. Amen. Praise God. Number one. God's word alone can bring revival when we humble ourselves and are filled with the Holy Spirit and ask God to powerfully pour the latter rain. Do you think when Peter preached, he used the most powerful PowerPoint? Did he use a projector? Did he use all the powerful satellites? No. How many people were converted when Peter preached the word of God in one day? How many? 3,000. Today, we preach 3,000 sermons, not even 100 baptisms. Why? We are not filled with the Holy Spirit. God wants the Paranaque Central Church to be filled with the Holy Spirit from today. Paranaque Central Church is going to be turned upside down because you're going to be filled with the Word of God from today. Amen? Beginning from today, this church must be a praying church, a humble church, a church that reads the Word. I'm going to tell you a story. And this story is found in one chapter. For the next few minutes, I want all of you to open your Bibles. Come with me to Jeremiah chapter 36. Everybody, please open your Bibles. Come with me to Jeremiah chapter 36. I'm going to give you all a chance. How many of you have really brought your Bibles? Can you lift your Bibles and show me? Please lift your Bibles. No, don't lift your smartphones, laptops, no. Only Bibles. Praise God. You have to bring your Bibles to the church. Everybody. Jeremiah. Have you all told? Jeremiah. Many of you are still opening. Let's go to Jeremiah. Try to find out soon quickly. I'll give you a few more seconds. Are you okay? Let's go to the wall. And it came to pass in the fourth year of Jehoiakim. What is the name of the king? Everybody follow this story. His name is called Jehoiakim. What did he do? Let's go to the word of God. This word came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Every time a preacher preaches, every time a pastor stands, it is not his word. It is not his human intellect or human opinion. This is the word of God. What did God tell him? Take a scroll of a book, write therein all the words that I've spoken unto you against Israel and against Judah and against all the nations from the day I spake unto you. What does the Bible say? It may be, let's do it. Jeremiah has a new ministry. For those of you who do not know how many years Jeremiah served, he was as a prophet for 23 years. For 23 years, Jeremiah received the word of God, and he spoke the word of God. But God gave him a new assignment. He gave him a new duty. What is that? Jeremiah, I don't want you to preach anymore. I don't want you to go and start divine service. Rather, you will stay in your house. You are not going to preach hereafter. You are going to write my sermon. Wow. God commands him to write those things that he had been giving him during the long 23 years of period. Today, because Jeremiah sat down and wrote the word of God, praise God, we have the book of Jeremiah in the Bible. Amen. What did God ask him to write? Please look into the Bible. Take a scroll of a book. Let me explain to you. Back in the Bible times, you didn't have the energy and the facility of a modern world like you and I have all the 66 books right here compact. What did they do? They took a huge, big scroll, and they would have several pieces of parchment, and they would wrap around two sticks. On this long sheet, there will be several columns of writing, and as the parchment was rolled from one side, it was written, the Bible says, God spoke to Jeremiah all the words against Judah. God commanded that I want you to take ink, write it in black and white. Let's go to the Lord. It may be, I like to read this, it may be, what does it say? The house of Judah will hear all the evil which I purpose to do unto them, that they may return every man from his evil way, that I may forgive their iniquity of their sin. You will find three beautiful words here. Evil, iniquity, sin. Do you know why does God give the Bible? I want you to know this, my friends. God gives the Bible that you and I will turn from our evil ways. How can you and I turn from evil ways if we have not read the Bible? How can you and I have the sins and the iniquities forgiven? There may have been many reasons why God called Jeremiah to write these beautiful prophetic words, so that Jeremiah could not go and misrepresent or misinterpret or misinform God's people. God's word is so powerful, he knew that there will be 2016 in Paranaque Church. My people will be reading the word of God. Sure. I want to tell you, my friends, number one, God wanted to give this that we will turn from evil. God wants to forgive your sins, my sins. There was also another reason why God gave this. You know why? God wanted to inform in advance and predict and prophesy the evil that King Nebuchadnezzar from Babylon is going to come and destroy you. I want to praise God for this. When the opportunities come to speak God's word boldly, I want you to know God always gives the word for the good of his people. God wants to save you today. He wants to save me. And the only way he will do is through the word of God. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God, and the word became flesh and dwelt in how many of our lives the word of God is dwelling. Number one, I have 5 points to make. The first point is God preserves the word for the good. But I want you to see there was a Bible burner in this story. God was going to send King Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, all the way from Babylon. He would come to Jerusalem. He would destroy the walls. He would break the gates. He would burn the gates. He was also going to destroy the temple. Let's look at this one. what we're going to look is more amazing. Number two, the second part of the message is God broadcasts His word to only the needy servants. If you don't feel the need for Jesus, do you cling the word of God? How many of you had your breakfast this morning? Raise your hand. Praise God for this group. I'm going to take you through another one. Let's go to verse 4. Jeremiah called Baruch, the son of Neriah. Who was Baruch? Let's listen to this story. Baruch was the secretary of Jeremiah. God gave words and message to Jeremiah. Jeremiah spoke, and here was Baruch sitting with a scroll, and he started writing as Jeremiah started dictating. It's not enough to God that it is simply written. Not all people can write and read. So God appointed, I will be the one to give you the message. You will be the one to receive the message, but he will be the one to write. But let us see who will go and preach this message. I want you to see what happens in the story next to Jeremiah. Apparently, he thought God had given these words only to Jeremiah. Do you know what was Jeremiah doing by now? Jeremiah was in the temple. He was confined. He was not allowed to go and preach. Jeremiah also wrote another book in the Bible. What's that book? What is the name of the book that Jeremiah wrote? Lamentations. You're going to go there. So we read, Jeremiah was not allowed to go and read this word in the temple to the people. But he was the prophet who received this message. What does this mean? Jeremiah calls his secretary. He calls his assistant to present God's word to the people. What did he do? Let's go to the wall. And Jeremiah commanded Baruch, saying, I am Shaphat, because the king was so angry that he wanted to put him in a dungeon. And you all know the story. He was for a long time put in the dungeon. They had to lift him up out of the pit. And here he says, I cannot go into the house of the Lord. That takes us to the next level. Please come with me to verse 6. I love to read this. Is there any volunteer here who would like to read for us this verse? Any volunteer? Who wants to read this? Any volunteer? Yes? Thank you.
Jeremiah,
these people are going to come and attack us. If that is the case, the perfect day to hear the word will be this day of the fasting day. Today God wants to speak to you. What is the second point? God always gives his word to the needy sinners. Let's go to point number three. I love to read this. I want all of you to kindly come here and see. Jeremiah received the word. Baruch started writing. He did not go and preach and proclaim. Rather, he waited. One day, he got the message, go on the fasting day. Number three. It may be that God's, they will present their supplication before the Lord and will return everyone. God authenticates his will to those who listen. I'm going to give you 1 minute. I want all of you to open your Bibles, please. I'm going to give you 1 minute. All of you will read silently 11 to 15. Take a minute, please. This is the time to read the Word of God. Everybody, read quietly verses 11 to 15. Number three, God authenticates his word to those who listen. Listen to this carefully, people. Who were the ones who heard Baruch speak these words? It was just the ordinary lay people, common people. They came to the temple, and when they were in the temple, they heard God's word in the temple. But in the temple, there was one official. Praise God for one official in Paranaque Church. One official heard the word. What was that? Who was that? He went and told the other officials, and they too heard. Don't underestimate the power of one official in your church. Amen. He can be a powerful official, an ambassador of God, to go around and bring other ambassadors, that we all will become ambassadors for Christ. Amen. What was the name of that ambassador? What was the name of the ambassador? Look at the Bible. Micaiah. What did he do? Wow. He went and had another meeting with all the other officials. He went straight to the king's house, that is, the palace. He went to the scribe's chamber, and all the officials were sitting there. The scribe and all of these princes. Then Micaiah, who heard, he was a government employee. He was an ambassador, he was an official. What did he do? He declared the word, the Bible. When Baruch read the book, then all the officials, they sent Jehudi. What did they say? You go to Baruch, say, you please bring the roll from where you read. So Baruch the secretary took the roll and he came to the officials. I want to tell you, my friends, if you read your Bible every day, God will take you to places that you have not imagined. Amen. Do you know why God cannot use you and me? Do you know why God cannot appoint and me in high places, he knows that you and I do not have a world. Can you go and draw from the BPI ATM if you have not deposited money? Yes or no?
No.
Can you draw the power from heaven if you have not been on your knees and if you have not read the Bible?
No.
I want to tell you, my friends, let's look here. This man, Baruch, was so filled with the word, he was taken to the king's palace. Praise God. And they said unto him, sit down now, read it in our ears. Baruch read it in their ears. I come from a very poor family. When I say poor, I come from an extremely poor family. We are five children. I come from the southernmost part of India. I cannot brag like any of you that we were all Adventists for generations. My forefathers, everyone, they're all Hindus working in the temple as priests. One day, the Seventh-day Adventists came to my village and they said, there is a true God by the name Jesus. He created the world in 6 days and he rested on the seventh day, and this is the Bible. My father was so excited to listen, and he says, this God is the one who created us. And they said, you have to work 6 days and rest on the seventh day. My father was a high-ranking official in the government of India. That same week, he resigned his job and was baptized into the Adventist Church. Amen.
Amen.
And he got such a high salary in the government, when he joined the church, his salary became 1/10. You know, it became a tithe. You know why? Because in the church, we are not paid high. But there is power in that 1/10, then you get 100. Amen.
Amen.
And five of us children were born. We had to go to school. I have to tell you, I had to stop my studies for some time because I did not have the money to study. All my friends wore good dresses. I didn't have money even to buy a toothbrush and a toothpaste. I had only one trouser, and every day I would wash it and dry it. And I did not have proper clothes to wear. I did not have good shoes. I did not look decent when I was growing up, and I longed to eat something, but I was so poor. One day I told God, Lord, I want to give my life to you. If you give me money, I will go and study to be a pastor. And I want to study this word every day. I took a challenge in my life. Every day I will read 10 chapters in my Bible. And if I don't read 10 chapters, I will not eat that day. I want you to take a decision like that. If you don't read the Bible, I will not eat. So for several years, I started reading every day 10 chapters. So I was in my third grade when I started reading the Bible. When I came to grade 7, I finished the whole Bible. Amen. From grade 3 to grade. So I started studying the Bible again and again and again until I had to go to college. Then I did not have the money to go to college. All my friends went advancing. I felt so bad. I became a student cold water. I started selling books. I got some money. I saved a little bit of money. And I went to the college to be a pastor, to be a student. They said, you do not have enough money, you have to go home. I felt so bad, Lord. I went with only 2,000 ordinary Indian rupees. This was in the year 1991, November month. I felt so miserable, Lord, how can you let me down? I went and prayed that night. I went prayed so hard, I got an admission. Throughout my college studies, I suffered. Didn't have proper money, no proper clothes, no proper food. It was tough. All my friends used to get pocket money, but I felt so miserable, and I started hating myself. And so the Lord told me, read your Bible. No money, no bank account, nothing, poverty, depression. you feel so dark. But I started reading the Bible. As I started reading the Bible, like Jeremiah, I started receiving the Word of God. I took God's Word seriously. And every week I had a chance to preach, I went around and started. I could never speak one paragraph of English. I want you to know. I told God, Lord, I want to speak English. If you help me to speak English, I will go and preach about you. I took my mother tongue Bible. I opened my mother tongue, kept it in one side. I opened my English Bible. I read one verse in English and I read one verse in my mother tongue. I read one verse in English, I read another one in my language called Tamil. Like that, I started reading the Bible. In 6 months, God helped me to speak English. Amen.
Amen.
I want to tell you to cut the story very short. One day, God helped me to graduate. I received an email. And in that email, it said, Pastor Paul, you are selected to speak at the General Conference as one of the devotional speakers. You're listening to a true story. God took me to the General Conference to preach the word. Amen?
Amen?
When I went and stood there, I had to go to the platform. The man said, hey, what are you going to do? I said, I'm going to preach. He said, are you going to preach in your mother tongue or English? Because this is United States. I said, I will try to speak in English. I want to tell you, God filled me with the Holy Spirit. I got onto the stage at the General Conference. I said, Lord, here is a poor boy from India. I don't have a good rich background like an Adventist, like all these folks. I do not have money. You brought me here. Fill me with Holy Spirit. God filled me with the Holy Spirit. By God's grace, when I preached the word, when I came down hardly, hundreds of people gathered around. They invited me all over the world. Today, you are listening to a poor, poverty-stricken, Hindu background pastor speaking. Today, God has taken me around the world. Not maybe not around the world in 80 days, but more than 80 days. He has put me in the most expensive place. I have eaten the great food of my life. Today, I have a hard time selecting which shirt to wear. I have a hard time. I went to the US. I started preaching. Right after that, there was a man who gave me a big suitcase. When I opened it, I found 64 shirts, brand new shirts. I want to tell you, do you want money? Do you want peace? Do you want food? Do you want recognition? Do you want employment? All you have to do is read the Bible every day. Amen. You don't have to be a rich man. You don't have to be a powerful man. Be humble. Every day listen to God's word. Say, Lord, I want to be filled with the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit comes down upon you, when God fills his word with you, you will be a Jeremiah. Look at what happens here. When Barak started reading this, go to the next one. Number four, the princess said to Barak, go and hide you and Jeremiah because the king is going to come and kill you. What is the name of the king? What is the name of the king? What is the topic for our study this morning? What is the topic of our study? The Bible. Let's go to the word. They went into the king, into the court, and they laid up the roll in the chamber of Elisha, the scribe, and told all the words in the ears of the king. God's will is that every king in this world must hear the word of God. Amen. The king of Saudi Arabia, Donald Trump, the president-elect, His Excellency Duterte, all the kings of this world need to listen to the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
When the Bible says, they went into the king sent Jehudi to fetch the roll, and he took it out of Elisha on the scribe's chamber, and Jehudi read it in the ears of the king, and in the ears of all the people. beside the king. Now let's see what this man is doing. The king sat in the winter house in the ninth month, and it came to pass when Jehudi had read 3 or 4 leaves, because he was like parchment. In other words, in today's version, hardly he left, he read 3 chapters. What did the king do? He cut the Bible with what? Pen knife. Anybody here has a pen knife? Can you raise your hand? Anybody here has a pen knife? Okay, I'm happy. And he cut the Bible and he cast it into where? The fire. Can you believe this thing? And that was on the road. Yet they were not afraid to rent their garments, neither the king nor any of his servants that heard all these words. Nevertheless, Elnathan, Deliah, Gemariah had made intercession to the king that he would not burn the roll, but he would not hear them. How many of us burn the Bible today like Jehoiakim? Every time you don't read the Bible, every day you're burning the Bible. Every time you read the Bible and transgress His commandments, you're burning the Bible. Every time you don't listen to the Word of God and don't listen to the preacher, you're burning the Bible. Husbands, if you're not faithful to your wives, you're burning the Bible. Children, if you're not obeying your parents, you're burning the Bible. Wives, if you're not obedient to your husbands, you're burning the Bible. This is a society where we have everything advocated based on human opinion, concepts, ideas. Let's look at the Lord. In spite of the intercession, please don't read the Bible. Don't use the penknife to cut the Bible. The Bible is a two-edged sword. Do you think a penknife can cut a sword? No. Let's look at the Bible burner. What happened? Now what happens? Do you think the book of Jeremiah was lost? If King Jehoiakim burnt the book of Jeremiah, how come we have the book of Jeremiah? Do you think Baruch took a photocopy before he gave it? I don't think so. How do you think you have the book of Jeremiah today if he had burnt the book? Let's go to the Bible. He burns the Word of God. He was in the winter house, just like December, the month of December. God told this country, this people, Judah, will be carried all the way to Babylon as slaves. And when Jehoiakim heard it, he could not understand. The Bible burner, King Jehoiakim, what did God say? The king of Babylon will certainly destroy Judah. When he heard this war, he could not stand. Let's go to the Bible. The king commanded Jeremiah, the son of Amalek, and Sarai, the son of Azrael, and Shelemiah, the son of Abdel, to take Baruch, the scribe, and Jeremiah, the prophet. He wanted to kill them. But I want all of us to read it together. Let's read it. But the Lord gave them. Do you know, friends? The devil wanted to kill all of you this morning on the way to the church this morning. Did you know that? But who protected you? God. I was getting ready for a fasting and prayer. I was traveling through Maguia. I came all the way from Bilia. I was going to get through Maguia, then get into Silo. All of a sudden, there was a robber. He took a huge stone and he hurled exactly at the car. He hurled at my side where I was sitting. I want to tell the truth. If that had hit me today, you would not hear Pastor Paul preaching. It hit exactly on the metal frame in the side. God protected me by 1 millimeter. Amen?
Amen.
I praise God. God will protect you from diseases. He will protect you from your enemies. He will protect you from all the evil forces if you have the power of God. Let's go to the Bible. Let's find out. The word of the Lord came to Jeremiah after that the king had burned the roll and the words which Pharaoh brought at the mouth of Jeremiah, saying, take thee again another roll. Amen. If anybody burns the Bible, God can rewrite the Bible. Amen. Nobody can burn the Bible in this world. Let's go to the world. And he said, write in it all the former words that were in the first roll, which Jehoiakim, the king of Judah, had burned. He burnt the Bible. But God said, I want you to write another one. Why? Because God never forgets the Bible. He's the one who writes the Bible. Amen. Let's go to the Lord. Very interesting. I like to read the next one. He says, go take another scroll. Stop writing the whole book of Jeremiah. And I'm going to tell you in particular, write Jeremiah 3600. Because those days we didn't have the chapters. What happened here? Then he took another roll. He gave it to Baruch the scribe, the son of Neriah. Look at the second blessing when the Bible is rewritten. Jeremiah, who wrote therein from the mouth of Jeremiah, all the words of the book which Jehoiakim, king of Judah, had burned in the fire, and there were added besides unto them many like words. Not only original, apart from that, God gave extra words. Amen. Now we are going to end this sermon. Let's see how the beautiful Bible ends this. He is now writing the second time. Baruch is seated. Jeremiah stands, receives the word of God. What's happening here? God will vindicate his goal and to fulfill it. Do you know what the trail it took for God's people to preserve this? Let's go and read this. You will say to Jehoiakim, king of Judah, thus said the Lord, you have burned this roll, saying, why hast thou written therein? The king of Babylon shall certainly come and destroy this land, and shall cause to cease from thence man and beast. Therefore thus said the king Jehoiakim, king of Judah, he shall have none to sit upon the throne of David, and his dead body shall be cast out in the day to the heat, and the night to the frost. I will punish him and his seed and his servant for their iniquity. I will bring upon them and upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem and upon the men of Judah all the evil that I have pronounced against them, but they harm it not. To cut the story, who was the son of Jehoiakim? Anybody who gives the right answer will get 2,000 pesos. Not from me, but from the ambassador. Anybody wants to say the name? Okay, I saved money for you, ambassador. I want to show you a true story. Can you have the volume? I'm going to show you a true story in the Bible. That was Jehoiakim. Now I'm going to show you another story in the history. It really happened. His name is called John Huss. John Huss was a great reformer. He was a great preacher. He preached the Bible, Bible, Bible. Do you know what did they do to him? Let's look at this. A true story in the history, church history. They told him, John Huss, recant. Don't believe in the Bible anymore. Don't read the Bible. Don't preach it anymore. If you are going to preach the word, we are going to put you on the stake. And we will burn. This is a true story. So they tied him to the stake. They tied him to the pole. The Roman Catholic Church said, this is the last chance for you to recant. Let's look at what the Pope told John Huss.
John Huss, this is your last chance to recant and abjure all your
life. Last chance. Either you burn your Bible or we will burn you. Let's see what John Huss has to say.
John, I must come to witness that all I have written and preached has been to rescue souls from sin. There can be no turning back. My Lord wants a man
into their hands, O God. I come in my spirit. Do you want to know what happened to John Huss? Watch this. A true story. This is what exactly happened to him. But do you know how did he die? John Huss died singing.
Everybody, give me the Bible, holy message.
the Spirit has to tell you. My son, my daughter, you have neglected the Word of God in your life. Don't you remember the times where, many years ago, you used to read 5 chapters, 6 chapters, and you used to spend so much time reading the Word of God, but now you are after shopping, you are after dining, you are after money making, you are after fame, you've forgotten me, you've neglected the Word of God, you have been burning the Bible, you have been in the winter, instead of getting warmed with the Word of God, you have been going into sin because you've not been spending time. I wrote this Bible to you, my son, my daughter. I have been giving this Word of God to change your life. And this is the only way I can change your life, because the Bible and Bible alone is the truth. Through Jesus, the Spirit of God can change you. You are not allowing me to speak to you on a daily basis. You are continuing to live in sin. Some of you have not read your Bible for months. Some of you have not read your Bible for years. And today, there is so much of sin. There is so much of power of evil and sin and sickness and darkness and abomination and iniquity and transgression. God is sending a second scroll. Will you please pray to God in your heart, Lord, I'm sorry. I've neglected your word. I've turned my back on your word. I've not been reading your word. I have been cutting the Word of God. There are times in the Bible when I came across a passage when I know I'm not supposed to steal, I'm not supposed to commit adultery, but I'm not supposed to dishonor my parents. I cut it and I transgressed because I was burning the Bible. Lord, I don't want to be a Bible burner. Rather, I want to be a burner for the Bible. Lord, I don't want to be Jehoiakim. I don't want to neglect the Word. I don't want to cut the Bible with a penknife. I don't want to burn the Word of God with fire. I don't want to trouble Jeremiah and Baruch, but I want to read the Bible. Lord, there are so many curses in my family because as a father, as a head, I've not had family worship. I've not gotten my wife and my children around the altar. We've not sung songs. We've not read the Word. We've not prayed. We've not dealt enough. Lord, from today, this is a special day. Jehoiakim proclaimed a fast. Today, Paranaque Church has proclaimed a fast. After a short break, Lord, again, we want to come this afternoon and we want to gather in your presence. We want to listen to the Word of God. Thank you for giving a second chance. Thank you for writing this scroll a second time. Thank you for sending this word a second time. We don't want to burn this second time. We are sorry for all that we've done. Wash us clean. Give us the new robe of righteousness of Jesus. Remove all the transgressions. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.